Hi, welcome to Savi's Fashion Studio. In one of our previous videos, we had shown using this ruffler presser foot for your electric home sewing machine, that is a portable machine. And we got many requests asking if there is similar ruffler foot for industrial or commercial sewing machine. So in this video, I'm showing the ruffler foot meant for industrial or commercial sewing machines. This is not for your electric home sewing machines. For more full-fledged online classes and to buy this ruffler foot, please visit our website servicefashionstudio.com. The link is given in the description. We'll see how to install it and use it. Now this ruffler feet attachment comes as a set. That is, there is an extra blade which goes here. There's a needle clamp and there is a die which has 8 grooves. The die already installed in this ruffler foot is with 4 grooves. That is, after every 4 stitches you get a pleat. When you want after every 8 stitches, you need to install this. So let's try this now. First of all, let's see how to install this. So before installing this ruffler foot, you need these tools, the hex key or Allen key, which is used to tighten this. So have the appropriate size, and also you would need a screwdriver. Now if you want to use this ruffler foot in your industrial or commercial machine, you need to have some patience because this will take some adjustment and settings to do before you start actually using it. This is available on our website servicefashionstudio.com, but buy it only if you have the patience to deal with it because it's not very easy. But I'll show you step by step and what may go wrong and how to adjust and all that. This is not an attachment where you can just fix and start your machine. This tool would be very useful if you have a sewing business, if you have a boutique, or if you're a tailor and if you do a lot of garments with pleats. This gives beautiful uniform pleats. So I am demonstrating on my Juki DDL 900B industrial sewing machine. First of all, switch off the machine, then remove the presser foot and also remove the needle. Remove this screw completely and keep the screws carefully because you will need it again to install. Now also remove the needle. Remove the screw completely. Remove the needle and the screw. Now there is a thread guide here. You need to remove this as well. You can just push it down. I'm placing all this in a small box so that I don't lose them. Now my machine also has this thread wiper which needs to be removed if I want to use the ruffler foot. So I just loosen the screws, 2 screws at the back, and remove this. I'll put it back later. Some machines may not have this, then you don't have to worry, you don't have to remove it. The latest machines don't have this wiper, it has nippers, so you don't have to worry. Now take this needle clamp. Now if you see here, one side is flat and the other side is bulging. So this bulging side should be towards me and the flat side should go to the other side. Now insert it in this way. Please don't forget this. This is very important. If you keep the flat side towards you, you will not be able to install this ruffler foot. It is very important. It took me a few hours to figure out what the problem was. Flat side should be away from me. The bulging side is facing me. Now insert it completely. If you are not able to insert, loosen both the screws on either side. For this you need this hex key. Now insert and see where this hole is and tighten the screw. This side I've tightened the screw. Now tighten this screw as well. Do not insert the needle yet. We'll do it later. Now raise the needle bar to the highest position by turning the hand wheel and raise the presser foot. Now when you lift this, the presser foot rises a little. You have to raise it completely using the knee lifter. You see here, it lifts even more. This is the max. Now take your ruffler foot. Now lift this to this position. Be very careful when you use your fingers because there are moving parts and your finger may get stuck somewhere. So do it carefully. Now this part here goes here in the needle clamp. If you find it difficult to move this, lift it high a few times, then it will be fine. So keep in this position because this has to sit here in the needle clamp. Now again, if you see here, this thread guide is coming in the way, so slightly turn it and keep it aside. Now this part is sitting inside the needle clamp. So once that is done, focus here where the presser foot should be tightened. Once this sits in, turn the hand wheel slightly and bring the needle bar down. So this goes up and this sits in here. Now I have released the knee lifter and now this is sitting here. Now tighten the screw. See that the hole in this and the presser foot bar is aligned, and then insert the screw and tighten. Tighten the screw completely using a screwdriver. Once this is done, don't start sewing. There is still more checking you need to do. Now lower the presser foot completely and see that it's sitting flat. Now slowly turn the hand wheel and make sure nothing is touching the body of the machine. Also, there is a possibility that this wheel here may touch the bulb here. So make sure all that is not happening. Now if you see, it is very close to the bulb here. And also if you see, instead of only the needle bar moving up, even the presser foot is lifting up, then what you need to do is, you need to do the adjustment here, that is remove this, and with the screwdriver, slightly loosen the screw and push the presser foot down, then tighten the screw. While tightening, push the screw down and tighten. Now again, check that no part is touching the body, and also, as you turn the hand wheel, the presser foot should not lift up. Again, if you see the presser foot is lifting, then loosen this screw and tighten this bar and then tighten the screw. Now if I turn the hand wheel, no part is touching the body or the bulb here. So now start slowly. So if you see here, after every 4 stitch, the blade moves, that means it bleeds. Now this installation is correct. Now we'll insert the needle. Now insert the needle here in this clamp with the groove in the needle to the left. Then tighten the screw here. So before inserting the needle, you need to raise the needle bar to the highest position. Tighten the screw completely. Now the last thing you need to check is that the needle is not hitting any of the part here or the presser foot. Slowly turn the hand wheel and make sure the needle is aligned here in the center. So this is fine, it's not touching any part. If it does, again loosen the screw, adjust the presser foot with the needle inside the presser foot. So now this is fine. Now we can start sewing. Even though I removed the thread wiper, the trimming operation is still on. Now this big screw here is to change the pleat depth. Now it's in the highest position, that means the max pleat depth. If you want to reduce, loosen this and bring to the center, or you can bring to the lowest by moving it down. Once you loosen the screw, it easily moves up and down. So you can take it to the lowest or you can keep in the center. Whatever changes you make, turn the hand wheel and confirm it's all working fine. And then do the actual stitching. Now let's start sewing and see how this pleats. This video is taking longer than expected. So in this part, I've only shown how to install the presser foot. In the next part, you'll see changing the die and sewing the ruffles on fabric. Thanks for watching this class. The link to the next video is given in the description below.